Uncle Billy's Secret.
Hi, Mouseketeers. Our Mouseka fable today is about a wolf and a house dog. A wolf who'd been having his troubles with taxes, high prices, and such, was down to his very last wolf skin, and that wasn't worth very much. Then he happened to meet with a house dog who looked so well-fed and so trim that the wolf had to ask how he did it, and the house dog explained it to him. I live in the house with my master, who feeds me roast beef every day. My job is to play with the baby and chase bill collectors away. You know, you could come to the village and live like us lucky dogs do. Try the help wanted ads in the paper and pick one that's suited to you. But the wolf was observing the house dog, and now it was plain to be seen that the fur on his neck was all flattened where a chain and a collar had been. No thanks, said the wolf. I'm a failure, but at least I'm as free as a breeze. I'll never trade food for my freedom, for here I can live as I please. Then the wolf shuffled off through the forest. But the moral is still very true. There's nothing as precious as freedom. Don't lose it, whatever you do. And now let's join the Mouseketeers.
Forever let us hold our banner high. Now it's time to say goodbye to all our company.
Soon.
K-E-Y.
Why? Because we like you.
M-O-U-S-E.
That's about all for today, Mouseketeers. But tomorrow, our big special, the Talent Roundup Show. See you then.
Next, get ready to exercise with Kellen, Goofy, and the rest of the gang on Mousercise.
Hi, I'm Gloria from Kids Incorporated with a checklist for Halloween safety. Wear comfortable, well-fitting costumes. Trick or treat with friends, never alone. Carry a flashlight and stay in well-lit areas. Always walk on the sidewalk, never in the street. Oh, and never eat anything unwrapped. And bring home all your candy so that your parents can inspect it before you eat it. If you follow these simple rules, you'll have no tricks with your treat.
Remember to breathe properly. You breathe in and breathe out. Now do it with me. And that's super. And if this is your first time with us, start slow and don't overdo it. If you have any shortness of breath, or you get tired or dizzy, or have any pain at all, stop. And if you have medical problems or physical handicaps, make sure to ask your doctor before joining us. But most of all, have fun and enjoy yourselves, because Mousercising is for the whole family. So ask everybody to join in. Okay, let's Mousercise! Breathe in and out on two. One, two, and shh. Again, and shh. Hands on hip and roll the head to the right four times. And one, two, three, and four. Other side. And one, two, three, and four. Let's reach up to the sky with the ladder. Picking the feet up when you go up that ladder. Stretch, stretch. That's it. And eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, and one. Good. Back in position. Arms up to the side and over to the right. And one, two, three, four. Over like a tabletop. One, two, three, four. And over the leg. And one, two, three, four. And up. Other side. And one. Good. Now stretch out like a table. Good. Now over that left leg. One, two, three, four, and up. Stretching those arms out to the side and over like a table. Good. Now small little pulses, making sure our backs are real straight. That's it. Heads up. Let's bring all of our weight now down to the ground, making sure that all of our weight is on our hands. And we have bubble gum on our heels. We're going to pick those heels up. And one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Bring them down and stretch your head between your legs. Stretch it out. Shake those heads. Whoop. There you go. Stretch them out and up. Now, put all of our hands on and press on the right knee and press. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Other side. And one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Good. Other side and single, single, single. That's it. Weight on hands. Six, seven, and eight. Rolling up, making sure the knees are a little bent. Breathe. And shh. Very good. One more. And shh. That was nice. Today's featured song is Bugaboo from the Mousercise album. We're going to be bugs. You ready? Let's go! Now let's flex and point our arms. That's it. Making sure we breathe in and out. And now bring it out in front of us. And that's it. Flexing up your hands. Good. Now out to the side. We're bees. Straight arms. Straight arms like a bee.
Bugaboo.
Bugaboo.
Roaches, bats, and beetles are the boys in the band.
Bugaboo.
Bugaboo.
Bugaboo. Bugaboo. Bugaboo.
That's it.
Bugaboo.
Well,
let's do the bugaboo.
Shake that leg. Shake that leg.
Bug, 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 bug,
You know what we are now? Mosquitoes!
Look out,
flap those wings!
Star of the show. Lovely little mosquitoes. No one else can do
get those wings going.
Get
the pins going.
She can give you a buzz.
Knees up.
Dancing, romancing, doing the bugaboo. Well, let's do the bugaboo. Come on and shake a leg or two.
We're spiders crawling up that wall. Let's get to our web.
He's dancing.
That's it now, sirs. We're going to be ladybugs now.
I'm a little lady.
I'm over our back. Making sure our knees are bent. I don't hear you breathing. Have a good time! Phew, that feels good. Well, you're getting your Mousercise mats. Here's the mouse that started it all, Mickey.
Now, here's something to keep in mind. Take a look at this interesting feature, especially from me to you.
Do you know why some people can eat more than others and not gain weight? Chances are it has to do with their activity level. If you're not very active, you probably aren't using up all the energy that you take in each day in the form of food. And that leftover energy is stored as extra fat. But if you use up all the energy you take in, you won't end up with any extra fat. That's one reason why active people can eat more, because they're using up that extra energy.
And now you know.
Is everybody ready?
Yeah!
Wonderful. Now remember to take off your shoes just like we have, so you can point your toes and stretch out your feet. And if you don't have a Mousercise mat, a nice big towel will do. Okay? All right. We're going to do our tummies right now. So, get up on the floor, on our backs, and breathe in. Feet up next to our bottoms. With our hands behind our ears, elbows open, and we're gonna do 8 slow sit-ups and then fast, okay? Okay. And 1, 2. I wanna hear you breathe. 4. 6. And 8. Now faster. And 1, 2. We're going to do the same thing. 8 slow and 8 fast. Let's go. And 1, 3, 5, 7. Now fast. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Now bring it into your chest. Stretch them in. Breathe in. And out. Ah, feels so good. Feels so good. Okay, let's go on a picnic. You ready? We're gonna be ants today, okay? Okay, let's get in the London Bridge position. Now we're gonna walk out on 3 with our hands and walk in on 3. And 1, 2, 3, and in. 1, 2, 3. Good, now the feet. 3 out and 3 in. And 1, 2, 3, and in. 1, 2. Good. Now let's stand there. Let's stand there where ants stuck in a cave. Good. And let's sit down on our knees. And we're going to do push-ups. And we're going to eat our cake. And take a bite. Take a bite of that cupcake. Mmm.
you say, Mousercisers?
Yeah!
Yeah! Get our knees up and stretch our heads to our feet.
Ah, now let's hurry up and cool down. And this cool down is the same every day, so you can use it before you play your favorite sport. Let's breathe in. And good. Now let's take the heads. One, two, three, four. Other side. One, two, three, four. Walk down. One, two, three, four, and up. One, two, three, four. Head rolls. One, two, three, four. Other side. One, two, three, four. Contractions forward and back. Forward and back, make sure you breathe, and good. Now let's bring our knees to our chest and out in front of us. And up and out. Point, flex. Point, flex. Point and flex. Point and flex. Seven and eight. Let's pull up to that ladder, pulling up. One, two, three, four, straight back. Five, six, seven, eight. Let's go down that ladder. Good. And hold. One, two, three, four. Go down on your back and bring the right knee to your chest. Keep the right shoulder on the ground. Push it to your left. Up. Right leg goes down, knee comes up, left, and pull it over, making sure that the left shoulder stays on the floor, Mousercisers.
Cool.
Extend and bring up to the chest and up to the sky and in second. And curl your feet up, 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 good, to the chest and in straddle position. And over to the right. Good, and up. Good boy, Marcus. How do you feel? Good. And up. One, two, three, four, on up. Toes back, making sure your toes are packed. Good girl. And up. Shake them out. Stand up. And breathe. And let's do one more. Ahead and roll. Two, three, four, five. Other side. And one, two, three, four, five, six. Mousercisers, relax. Drop the head.
Hi, Chris. Hi, Jenny.
Hi, Steve.
How you guys doing?
Fine.
You know what this is?
No.
This is a picture of a fly's nose magnified umpteen million times.
No.
No? Well, then it's a floor plan of a skinny room with no ends.
No.
I don't think so.
No? How about the skid marks at the end of a bicycle race?
Uh-uh.
Well, then what is it?
Equal sign.
Right. It's an equal sign. You know, there are just so many things in our life that just need to be equal. What do you suppose would happen if we didn't take the garbage out every day? Right, it'd build up. It'd just keep getting more and more, wouldn't it? That's why... it looks like somebody's already got the message here. Good job, Goof. Oh. You know, if we take in more energy or more food than we can use up in one day, that extra energy or food is stored in our body as fat. And that's why exercise is a great way to use up that extra energy so we don't have it left over like the garbage. You know, we're using up energy right now as we speak. You know that? We really are. Do you know what a calorie is?
It's a measurement of energy in food and your body.
Well, Jesse, very good. It is. It's a measurement of the amount of energy in our food and our body. Exactly right. You know, how old are you, Chris?
12.
And what kind of activities do you like to do, besides mousercising?
Oh, I like soccer and sometimes baseball.
Good. Well, for your age, height, and the amount of activity you do, let's see how many calories you need each day. 2,400. Now, that doesn't seem like a whole lot, but it is. Now, wait. Didn't he just come? Well, anyway, Chris, if you take in 2,400 calories, you've got to burn up the same amount of calories, right? Now, we burn up a lot of calories just for staying alive. Well, let's just see how many calories we're burning up just sitting here talking, okay? Have a guess?
50.
90 calories. Now, if we were exercising, jogging, or swimming, how many calories do you think we'd be burning up?
400.
350. Now, you see why exercise is so important. You've got to burn up all that extra energy, and because it's so much better and faster than just sitting around, right? Okay. Wait, Goofy, now, you've been back here 3 or 4 times now. Why don't you just throw that thing away? Oh, wait. Oh, Goofy, you've been carrying that for exercise, haven't you? What do you got in there? Oh, Goofy. That must weigh a ton. You know, you're just a chip off the old rock. And don't take that for granted.
So, do y'all feel great?
Yeah!
Well, that's just one of the benefits of Mousercising. You know, you don't have to be a kid to enjoy Mousercising. Let's make Mousercise a real family experience. So until next time, keep on Mousercising!
Next, wake up with Mickey, Donald, and the rest of the gang for a half hour of non-stop cartoon fun on Good Morning Mickey.
Thank you. Sonny Melendres creates a world where the key is parents and kids being involved with each other. It's a joyful environment, but it's more. It's a growing place for young, curious minds.
So get ready to learn, to explore, to use your imagination, and make sure you have your partner with you.
It's an active experience, and Sonny makes it fun because he loves what he does, and he believes in it. Sonny seems to know that the word sharing never means more than when you're a kid.
The
Macaroni Symphony Hour. Presenting another magnificent program of distinction by that master hand, that connoisseur and dilettante, that untiring seeker of new talent, Sylvester Macaroni, who again with his keen perception has unearthed a new find, a great discovery, that brilliant virtuoso and genius of the symphony, Maestro Michel Mouse, who is to be our guest conductor for this evening. And now the maestro is approaching the podium. He raises his baton, and we hear...
Thank you.
Thank you. carrot?
Wow!
a wonderful neat little girl. You're as sweet as can be. Just a glance at you lit up the sky. And oh, what a thrill came into my heart. Little boy, with your cute little ways, I am yours for the rest of my days. And this great big world will be divine, little girl.
We got the world on a plate, can't wait to start the day. Bells are ringing and birds are singing and we can hear the whole world say. Here's to a wonderful morning, let's get this day underway. Good morning and good morning, it's gonna be a great, yes, a real great, it's gonna be a great day.
The adventures of Pooh, Owl, Tigger, and Eeyore as they learn while having fun on Welcome to Pooh Corner.
Are you afraid of things that go bump in the night? If so, lock all your doors, lock all your windows, because this Halloween weekend's going to be a scream on the Disney Channel.
I am more frightened. I'm twice more frightened.
It's time for the Fantasy Film Festival.
Well, I'll be Grinched.
A ghoulish collection of frightfully funny and exciting movies and specials guaranteed to make your head spin.
It gets worse year after year.
On Halloween night, trick or treat with us as we present the classic tales of Ichabod and Mr. Toad. Dr. Seuss's Halloween is Grinch Night. The terrifying Anna to the Infinite Power and the Devil and Daniel Webster. Then on Saturday night, November 1st, the ghostly fun continues with Blackbeard's Ghost, the fantasy film world of George Pal, and Sinbad and the Eye of the Tiger. The Fantasy Film Festival coming October 31st to the Disney Channel. Donald Duck always goes to bed on time. His friends admire and respect him. He always remains calm. Even more importantly, he's terribly modest. If you look deep into his eyes, you'll find a complex personality. But the thing that launched his career is his sympathy for the human condition. Watch Donald Duck Presents and learn why, when people see Donald, they yell, "Duck!" Every weekday, enjoy a special selection from award-winning Disney series on science, nature, music, and comedy. Walt Disney Presents.
And how do you do? Everybody's waiting here at Pooh Corner, waiting for you and Winnie the Pooh to have a happy Ooty-Poo time.
Gloomy old Eeyore nods his head. He worries away the time.
Thanks for noticing me.
Owl makes his speeches long and loud without any reason or rhyme.
And I remember my Aunt Matilda on my uncle's side. My Uncle Orville, that is, who often said to me,
"The rabbit is busy pulling weeds. His carrots grow tall and sweet.
Jenga is baking pies and cakes that little Roo's waiting to eat.
And Piglet forever cleaning house is doing his daily sweep.
What a mess.
Tigger keeps bouncing up and down, perfecting his tiggerly leaps.
Say, this is tiggerific!
And here comes Winnie the Pooh.
Winnie the Pooh. Tubby little cubby all stuffed with puppies. Winnie the Pooh. Winnie the Pooh.
Welcome to you. I'm Winnie the Pooh. Everybody's waiting here at Pooh Corner, waiting for you and me, Winnie the Pooh, to have a happy hoop-de-poo time.
Let's have a happy hoop-de-poo time.
Oh, hello. Welcome to Pooh Corner. How do you like my music box? I just wind it up, and it plays a pretty tune. I like music a lot. It's fun to listen to music, and it's also fun to sing along, no matter how you sound. Our friends at Pooh Corner found out just how much fun it is to sing with others. And it all began with our good friend, Owl. I'd love to tell you about it. So let's pretend we're walking by Owl's house on a very nice day. The sun was shining, the birds were singing, and Piglet was skipping along.
Oh, how pretty.
Oh,
I never heard a bird sing like that before. It does remind me of Owl, though.
Me.
It is Owl.
Dum, 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 dum. Oh, Piglet, hello.
Hello.
I'm coming down to see you. Now, what are you doing here today, Piglet? Is there something I can do for you?
Oh, no, Owl. I was just listening to you sing. You're very good.
Oh, thank you, Piglet, thank you. You know, I was taught by my second cousin, Ulrico Caruso, one of the world's great opera singers.
Well, you sing very nicely. I wish I could sing like that.
You do? Let me think. You know, Piglet, I'm sure you could learn to sing if you took some singing lessons from an expert.
Expert? You mean Ulrico Caruso?
No, I mean me. Why don't you meet me at the Six Pine Trees this afternoon, and I'll teach you to sing.
Oh, it sounds wonderful. But what will we do?
Just sing a song like I do. We'll practice every note until we like the sound. We'll exercise the throat, up the scale and down. Sing la 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 like the birds in the trees. Sing la 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 just as long as you please. We'll and ooh, till you la 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 like I do. We'll sing.
Will I sound just like you?
We'll sing.
Can it really be true?
We'll and ooh, till you la 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 like I do.
See you at the Six Pine Trees. I can hardly wait.
Bye-bye, Piglet. Bye-bye, Piglet. Piglet could hardly wait for Owl to arrive for the lessons.
Oh, I hope he's going to show up.
Well, there's nothing like a student who always shows up on time.
I didn't want to miss any of my singing lessons.
Well, let's begin then. Now, class, the first thing to remember is to listen carefully to what you're singing. Listen. Do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, ti, do. Now, you try it along with me. Do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, ti, do.
How did I do?
Well, Piglet, you did fine. Except you must sing lower if you're going to sing like me. Try this note. Me, 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 me.
Me, 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 me.
Oh, dear. This isn't quite what I expected. Can't you sing a little lower?
Let's try.
Oh, no, that's not quite it, Piglet. You just don't sound like Ulrico Caruso. You don't sound like me, either.
I wanted to sound just like you, Owl.
I guess I'm not a very good teacher, Piglet.
Oh, it's not your fault. I guess piglets just don't sound like owls.
Owl and Piglet were both very disappointed about the singing lesson. You see, they didn't realize that not everybody sounds the same. But they did realize that they weren't able to sing together very well. Al was feeling very sad after Piglet left, until he saw another one of his friends.
Who's there?
Just me, Owl. I didn't think you'd notice me.
Hello, Eeyore. What were you doing behind those bushes?
I was listening to you teaching Piglet to sing. You sure sing pretty, Owl.
Oh, well, thank you. But I didn't do a very good job teaching Piglet to sing. His voice is too high.
You know, I was thinking I'd sure like to learn to sing pretty. But I don't suppose you'd like to teach me.
Well, now, let's see. Your voice isn't high, like Piglet's. Perhaps I could teach you, Eeyore.
You could? What do I do?
Practice every note until you like the sound. Exercise the throat, up the scale and down. We'll sing.
Will I sound just like you?
We'll sing.
What will we do?
We'll ah and ooh till you la 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 like I do.
So, you see, it's very simple, Eeyore. Now, try this.
Do, re, mi, fa, so, la, ti, do.
Do, re, mi, fa, so, la, ti, do.
Well, that's very good, Eeyore. Very good indeed.
It is?
Well, yes. Yes, it is. I must be a better singing teacher than I thought. Now, let's try it together.
Okie dokie, Owl.
Do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, ti, do.
Uh-oh. Something sounds kind of funny.
Yes, Eeyore. Your voice is too low. Can't you sing a little higher?
Higher? Well, I guess I can try. Is this high enough, Owl?
Oh, no, that's not what I mean. I mean, your voice should be higher.
Okie dokie, I'll try. Do, re, mi, fa, so, la, ti, do.
Oh, that wasn't higher, Eeyore. It was exactly the same. Oh, it's no use. I'm just not as good a teacher as old Rico Caruso.
Gee, Owl. I'm sorry you feel bad about it. It's probably all my fault.
Owl went home and he still felt sad that his singing lessons had not worked out. But he kept on practicing.
Even if I can't teach my friends to sing, second cousin Owl Rico Caruso would want me to continue. La 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 la. Come in.
Hello, Owl.
Oh, hello, Rabbit.
I heard some music and I wondered what was going on.
I was just practicing my singing. You know, Rabbit, I hate to sing alone, but I have no choice. No choice at all.
What do you mean?
Well, I tried to teach Piglet to sing with me, but his voice was too high. And I tried to teach Eeyore to sing with me, and his voice was too low. So I guess I'm just going to have to keep singing all alone.
Hey, I have an idea. You could teach me to sing.
Well...
My voice isn't real high or real low. My voice is in between. And I'd love to learn to sing. Oh, please, Owl, teach me.
Well, I suppose I could try.
That's the spirit, Owl. What do I have to do?
Well, just sing like I sing.
Sing la 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 like the birds in the trees. Sing la 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 just as long as you please. Ah and ooh till you la 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 like I do. We'll sing.
Will I sound just like you?
We'll sing.
Tell me, what will we do?
We'll ah and ooh till you la 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 like I do.
Now, try this.
Do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, ti, do.
Here goes. Do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, ti, do.
Excellent, excellent. You're a good student. Now, we'll sing it together.
Do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, ti, do.
Oh, no.
Oh, my goodness.
Rabbit, your voice may not be too high or too low, but you don't sound like me at all.
No, and you don't sound like me either.
You have a nice voice, Rabbit, but I'm afraid we can't sing together.
No, Owl, I'm afraid not. But thanks for the lesson. I learned a lot.
Oh, it's no use. Owl was feeling worse and worse because he wasn't able to sing with his friends. In fact, he was so upset, he decided to take a walk. And his walk took him to Piglet's house. Piglet was also upset about the singing lesson. And he was trying to cheer himself up by practicing his xylophone.
Oh, dear. Who is it?
It's just me, Piglet, your former singing teacher.
Oh, come on in.
Well, I was just flying around the 100-acre wood, and I needed someone to talk to. Oh, Piglet, not only was I unable to teach you to sing opera, but I was also unable to teach Eeyore and Rabbit.
I'm sorry, Owl.
It's no one's fault but my own. I just wish I understood it. You know, when I sing, it sounds one way. La, 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 la. And when you sing, it sounds another way.
Yes, like this. La, 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 la.
And when Rabbit sings, it sounds somewhere in between.
Like this. And when Eeyore sings, it sounds like this.
It's too bad they don't sound right together.
Yes, it's too bad. And when you put them all together, it sounds like this.
Why, Piglet, that didn't sound too bad.
No, in fact, it sounded lovely. Ow, maybe we could all sing together, like this.
Why, Piglet, you may be right. We don't have to sing exactly the same to sing together. Piglet, tomorrow afternoon, meet me at the 6 pine trees. And bring Eeyore. And Rabbit!
I will, Owl. Bye. It just might work.
And the very next afternoon, Owl was waiting anxiously for his friends to arrive.
Oh, my good fellows, I'm so glad to see you.
Gee, thanks for inviting me, Owl. But what are we doing here?
We're singing.
Together?
That's right.
But how? I sing too low.
And Piglet sings too high. And I sing too, in between.
Piglet and I would like to try a little experiment. We'd like you to sing the notes the way you did yesterday. Piglet, you sing high. And Eeyore, you sing low. I'll sing up here. And Rabbit, you sing in between Piglet and me. Now, let's each sing our notes.
La, 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 la.
Ready?
La.
Oh, could we try that again?
Most definitely. Here we go.
La.
I think we've got it.
You mean I'm not singing too low?
And I'm not singing too up in between?
Oh, I know. We're all singing in harmony.
The friends were very excited when they discovered they could sing together, even though they sang different notes. Singing different notes that sound nice together is called singing in harmony.
By Jove, I think we're good enough to form a singing society.
What's a society?
Well, it's a group of owls. I mean, friends who get together to do something. Why, we owls have a singing society, a dancing society, a sewing society, a cooking society, a playing society, and a sitting society.
How about a gardening society?
Oh, that too. So, tonight will be the first meeting of the Pooh Corner Singing Society. Now, we'll all meet here. I'll give you your parts, and you must practice.
Practice?
Practice?
Practice.
So they practiced.
Boom, 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 boom.
And practiced.
La, 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 la.
And practiced.
La, 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 la.
And that night, the Pooh Corner Singing Society met for the very first time.
Well, did each of you practice your part? Very well. We'll begin.
Ba-bum, bum, bum, bum.
Harmony, sweet harmony.
What a lovely sound.
Though we sing quite differently,
together we have fun.
Boom, 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 boom.
Harmony, sweet harmony.
What happiness it brings.
When good friends get together, and everybody sings.
We did sound good singing together, didn't we?
We sure did.
And we owe it all to our teacher, Owl.
Thank you, but I couldn't have done it without your help and cooperation. As my second cousin, the famous Owl press star, Owl Rico Caruso, once said, music maketh the hearts of owls to sing. And I think we can all learn a valuable lesson from this experience. That is, we can all learn, we all learn something. I've just forgotten what. Oh, yes, yes. As I was saying, we all learned that we can all sing together, even if we sound different.
Yep. High and low and in between.
You know, I'd like to try some other ways of singing, too.
Other ways of singing?
Yes. Why don't we try fast and slow?
Fast and slow? Ooh, you might have something, but it will require more practice.
So the very next day, all the members of the Pooh Corner Singing Society practiced again. Only this time, they practiced singing fast.
Boom, 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 boom.
La, 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 la. La, 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 la.
La, 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 la. La, 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 la.
And that night, they returned to the 6 pine trees.
The second meeting of the Pooh Corner Singing Society has now begun. Places, everyone. Before we begin, let me remind you that we should all sing carefully, prettily, and, what else? And fast.
Bum-bum-bum-bum.
Harmony, harmony.
What a lovely sound.
Though we sing quite differently,
together we have
bum, 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 bum.
Harmony, harmony.
Each one knows his part.
We join in all together and sing it from the heart.
I sing high.
I sing low.
We sing in the middle.
We can sing it fast or slow if we try a little.
Harmony, harmony, what happiness it brings.
When good friends get together
and everybody sings.
Singing with your friends is a lot of fun. And the way our friends sang different notes that all sounded nice together is called singing in harmony. You know, no two people sing alike because no two people are alike. And our friend Tigger has a song about that. Will you help out Tigger by singing along? You will? Get ready then, because here comes Tigger.
It's what you do with what you got. And are you really nice or not? If you're thoughtful and you're true,
one can compare to you.
Hold your head up high. Look yourself right in the eye. Proud of who you see. Proud of who you see.
Cause you're the only you. And I'm the only me.
No one else sounds like Tigger because no one else is like Tigger. And you know, there's only one friend at Pooh Corner who is small and big. Do you know who that is? Of course, Piglet. And he's in the thoughtful spot right now. Let's see what he's doing, shall we?
What kind of sounds do you like best, Piglet?
Oh, I like high sounds the best. Like this one.
That bell certainly is high.
What's that?
I don't know, Piglet, but it is a low sound.
But I'm not sure I like it, because I just don't know what it is.
Piglet. Oh, Piglet.
Oh, but I do know what that sound is. It's Eeyore.
Howdy, Piglet. I was looking all over for you. How do you like my new bell?
It's very nice, Eeyore.
Yep, it has a nice low sound. I like low sounds.
And I like high sounds. High.
Low.
It's too bad you don't have some other sounds there.
But we do.
Well, what do you know?
As high as my bell.
And it's not as low as my bell.
Why don't you check the noise box again?
Oh, another bell.
And that's lower than the other bell, isn't it?
Yes, it is. You know, I have a good idea. We could use the high sound and the low sound.
How do we do that, Piglet?
Ready, Eeyore?
Ready.
When you put high sounds and low sounds together, you could play a song. Well, did you like Piglet and Eeyore's song? So did I. And now our friend Pooh has a song that's all about the part of the body that helps you hear sounds. Your ears. So let's use our ears and listen to Pooh.
My ears are here upon my head. They let me know when something's said. They help me if I sing along when I hear a pretty song. Oh, my ears can make me happy when a honeybee appears. She leads me to the honey with a buzz, buzz, buzz. I'm so glad that I have ears. Cause my ears are a part of me that you should know. I take them along wherever I go. They grow out of me quite naturally. My ears are a part of me. My ears can tell me who is who when I hear someone call out who. Piglet says,
Pooh.
If it's Tigger, it's Pooh. Oh, my ears are very handy if something dangerous appears. When I hear or a I'm so glad that I have ears. Cause my ears are a part of me that you should know. I take them all along wherever I go. they grow out of me quite naturally. My ears are a part of me.
You know, your ears are an important part of you, so use them to listen to the sounds around you, high and low and in between. You know, I hate to hear the sound of someone saying goodbye, but our time is over for today. I've had so much fun, and I hope you have too, but I'll be back again soon with lots more fun with all our friends at Pooh Corner. Please join me then. Have a very nice day today.
It's time to say toodaloo. The minutes just flew. We were having so much fun at Pooh Corner. Sorry it's true, but what can we do? We're running out of poo-poo good time. Go on and wear a big smile. And after a while, we'll be having fun again at Pooh Corner. But for today, we'll just have to say toodaloo, so long and goodbye.
Up next, join Donald, Mickey, and the whole gang with some crazy animated antics on Donald Duck Presents.
Stand on your head.
The Peanuts Gang has landed on the Disney Channel.
My blanket! I can't be without it!
There's Linus, Snoopy, Lucy, and their most lovable hero.
Ah, there it is, the old pitcher's mitt.
Join the fun with the Peanuts Gang.
Just can't seem to do anything.
And a boy named Charlie Brown.